ഹലോ
ടീച്ചറെ
എല്ലാവർക്കും നമസ്കാരം. നമ്മുടെ ജില്ലാ ആയുർവേദ ആശുപത്രി വർക്കലയുടെയും AMA ആറ്റിങ്ങൽ ഏരിയയുടെയും വെബിനാർ സീരീസ് ആണ്. അതിൽ 16-ാമത്തെയാണ് ഇന്ന് നടക്കുന്നത്. ഇന്ന് അകിത തന്ത്രത്തിലെ പ്രത്യേക യോഗങ്ങളെക്കുറിച്ചാണ്. നമ്മുടെ BPSC ആയുർവേദ കോളേജിലെ ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെൻ്റ് ഭാഗ തന്ത്രം ഡോക്ടർ ഗോപികൃഷ്ണനാണ്. അതുപോലെ നമ്മുടെ വെബിനാറ് ഇപ്പോൾ ഈ സർട്ടിഫിക്കറ്റ് നമ്മൾ ഇഷ്യൂ ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ട്. വളരെയേറെ ശ്രദ്ധ പിടിച്ചു പറ്റുന്ന രീതിയിൽ ഫാക്കൽറ്റികളുടെ പ്രത്യേകത കൊണ്ട് പ്രാക്ടീസ് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു പുതിയതായിട്ട് കടന്നു വരുന്ന ഒരു മെഡിക്കൽ ഓഫീസർമാർക്ക് വളരെയേറെ പ്രയോജനം ഉണ്ടാകത്തക്ക രീതിയിലാണ് ഇപ്പോൾ ക്ലാസ്സുകൾ മുന്നോട്ട് പോകുന്നത്. നമുക്ക് ഇപ്പോൾ സൂം കൂടാതെ തന്നെ നമ്മുടെ യൂട്യൂബിൽ ഇത് അപ്ലോഡ് ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ട്. ഒരു പഠന സ്വഭാവവും തുടർ പഠനം എന്നുള്ള നിലയ്ക്ക് നമുക്ക് വളരെ പ്രയോജനം ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു വെബിനാർ സീരീസാണ്. ഇന്ന് ഇന്നത്തെ നമ്മുടെ ചീഫ് ഗസ്റ്റിനെ ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നത് നമ്മുടെ പൂജപ്പുരയിലെ സൂപ്രണ്ടായിരുന്ന ഡോക്ടർ മഞ്ജു ആണ്. മഞ്ജു ടീച്ചറിനെ ഞാൻ ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നതിന് വേണ്ടി ക്ഷണിക്കുകയാണ്. ഹലോ ഡോക്ടർ അശ്വതി. ഹലോ.
സാർ ഞാനുണ്ട്, ടീച്ചറുണ്ട്.
ആ ടീച്ചറിനോട് പറയാൻ പറയൂ.
ടീച്ചറേ ടീച്ചറെ കേൾക്കാമോ?
ടീച്ചർ ഓഡിയോ ഓൺ ചെയ്തോ? സബിൻ
ഓഡിയോ ഓൺ ആണ് സാറേ. ടീച്ചറെ
ഫോൺ വെച്ചിട്ട് അങ്ങോട്ട്. ഹലോ അശ്വതി. ഹലോ സബിൻ, ഇത് അവർ റെസ്പോണ്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നില്ല. അശ്വതിയും കാണുന്നില്ല. ഡോക്ടർ മഞ്ജു
മഞ്ജു ഡോക്ടർ ഓഡിയോ ഓൺ ആക്കിയിട്ടില്ല.
അപ്പം ഓഡിയോ ഓൺ ആക്കാൻ പറയും. ഒരു വിളിക്കുമായിരിക്കും.
ടീച്ചറിന് ഓഡിയോ എന്തൊരു ഇഷ്യൂ ഉണ്ട്? ഇപ്പം
വീഡിയോ അങ്ങ് ഓഫ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറഞ്ഞാൽ മതി, അപ്പൊ ഓഡിയോ കുറച്ചുകൂടെ ക്ലിയർ ആവും.
അല്ല മാം, ഹലോ ഹലോ മഞ്ജുവിന്റെ ഓഡിയോയ്ക്ക് പെർമിഷൻ കൊടുത്തില്ല. ഓഡിയോയുടെ ഏറ്റവും താഴെ ഇടതുവശത്ത് ഓഡിയോയ്ക്ക് പെർമിഷൻ കൊടുക്കാനുള്ള ഒരു ഇതുണ്ട്. അതായത് അൺമ്യൂട്ടിന്റെ അവിടെ ചെക്ക് ചെയ്യാൻ മതി, അപ്പൊ പെർമിഷൻ കൊടുക്കും. പെർമിഷൻ
കൊടുത്തിട്ടില്ല.
ഇപ്പോഴും മ്യൂട്ട് ആണെന്ന് തോന്നുന്നു.
അശ്വതി അശ്വതി ഹലോ
ആ സാർ കേൾക്കാം സാർ
അശ്വതി ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്തോളൂ സാർ വെയിറ്റ് ചെയ്യില്ല നമുക്ക് വാട്ടർ ടാങ്ക്സിന് വിളിക്കാം
ആ ടീച്ചർ റെഡി ആയിരിക്കും സാർ ഇപ്പോൾ ഒരു
അതിൻ്റെ ശ്രീലക്ഷ്മി എന്താ ഹാൻഡ് റൈസ് ചെയ്തത് സബിൻ ശ്രീലക്ഷ്മി എന്താ ഹാൻഡ് റൈസ് ചെയ്തത് വെറുതെ ആണോ അശ്വതി ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ഇൻവൈറ്റ് ചെയ്തോളൂ നമുക്ക് പിന്നെ അത് അവർക്ക് പിന്നെ നമുക്ക് കൊടുക്കാം ശരി ആയിക്കോട്ടെ ഭാഗ്യ
ഹലോ
ആ ഭാഗ്യ പറഞ്ഞോളൂ അവർക്ക് എന്തോ ഓഡിയോ പ്രോബ്ലം
A warm welcome to everyone. Thank you for joining today's webinar. Your active participation is important throughout the session. I am Bhagya, a representative from GDAH Varkala. Today we are presenting on the topic Agada Yoga in Clinical Practice, presented by Dr. Gobi Krishna S. Before we get started, I would like to say that if you have any questions during the presentation, kindly mention them into the question box. And all the delegates are requested to fill the form for e-certificate. The link will be shared in chat box as soon as possible. Now, without further ado, I would like to introduce before you Dr. Gobi Krishna S, who secured his BAMS from SDM College, Udupi, and post-graduation in the subject of Agada Tantra. He was working as assistant professor in Department of Agada Tantra at SDM College, Ayurveda College, for 4.5 years. Since 2012, he is continuing as assistant professor in Agada Tantra at VPSB Ayurveda College, Kottakkal. I cordially invite Dr. Gobi Krishna to this presentation, and I once again invite all the delegates to this section. Thank you.
Thank you.
Sir, please.
Thank you for the introduction. Shall we directly go for the topic?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Thank you. And with the presence of my dear teacher, Manju teacher, it actually took me to surprise. The teacher is also watching me. Because she has always been a very good guide and very affectionate to me since my PG days, and still she is having a great care towards me. That is what I feel, sir. So with her permission, I'm beginning the topic Agada Yogas in Clinics. Recurrence 2 or 3 weeks. I hope I am audible now. If at all there is any issue, kindly inform me so that if the network goes off.
Yes.
And if any question, please as Dr. Bhagya had told, please drop your messages so that I will be able to answer it if I know, if I would be able to tell the answers, or else definitely I'll refer and tell the answer. Vagartha vivasam prattav, vagartha pratipattaye, jagata pitaro vande, parvati parameshwarav. Hatha yogas in clinics has been a lot of, what to say, has underwent a lot of churning in me for the past 12 years, right from the days of my PG, and at the same time during my academic service and also during my clinical practice. So with my limited knowledge for the past 12 years in Nagada OP, with the proper guidance of my teachers and their help and constant encouragement, whatever I have seen, I would like to share my experience in my clinics. Is the slide visible?
Okay, sir.
Yes. This is one of the we would not take a lot of time in discussing about the cases. So because Agada Yogas is our area, so as and when that yogas will be discussed, we will be discussing about that particular case which we are going to see the see now. Please remember the photographs which we are discussing, and I will remind it later also. This is a case of Darvikara Damsha, a cobra bite which had come to our OP. With the initial management from an allopathic medical college, and this was the situation on the day that she had visited our OP. The area was gangrenous, the ulcer was suppurated, she had gross inflammatory features with fever, and her diabetes level shot up to 300 above. And this is what we had got the result. After a month and a half of treatment, we had saved the finger. She had complete relief from all those features. And at the same time, we could manage her raised diabetic level also with our medication. This is Mandali Damsha, a case of Russell's viper bite with classical pythika features, swelling, and this had come right on the day one of the bite. And on the ring finger, you can see on the tip of the ring finger the bite. And in 4 days, on the fifth day, the photo was taken, and this is what the result is. The third case is that of Luta Visha. These are all confirmed cases of Luta. This is how the patient had come to our OP. It was there in her dress. She had crushed the lesion. She had crushed that spider, and which caused the spread of that much area. And this is what we had rendered the result. This is another case of Luta Visha. Eschar formation. It's called eschar formation, and it's a suppurated tissue, a gangrenous tissue that we can see on the chin. The patient had gone for a local treatment for 1 day, and on the second day, the patient had visited our OP. The first photo is on the day one, and the second photo is on the subsequent visit in 1 week, and this is today's situation. And he was advised for after healing of this wound, he was advised for a plastic surgery, a reconstruction surgery for the lost muscle tissue on that area. But without any surgery, we were successful in maintaining those tissues intact. We could avert that reconstruction surgery also, and this is what the result that we had given in a span of 1 month. This is another case of Visarpa. Now all these bite cases are over. These are the conventional cases that we get in Visarpa. This boy of 26 years had developed, he is a farmer in Thrissur, and he had developed these lesions in a single day. The day he had cleaned his field, cleaned his palm. On that evening, he started the lesion, and on the next day, this was the situation. If you see the third photo, the area is totally suppurated. Pustules had developed on day 3 or 4. And this is what he is today. And within 2.5 to 3 weeks of duration, this is what the lesion is in present. This last photo that he had sent me. This is a case of suspected Ketodamsha. Acid fly is what is suspected, but I don't know because there is no confirmed history of this. He is a small boy of 4 years. Had come to our OP with these blisters, with fever, and without any external medication, in a duration of 1 week, the second photo is post treatment, 1 week of duration. This is a case of, again, another Visarpa case. And at present, he is under my treatment now. And I would like to share a video of this child. I'm going to mute the volume also, because his cry is a little bit painful to hear. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
And this is the photo. This is the video that he had sent me on the fourth day of the lesion. After that video, he had taken the medicine on that day one itself. The first video was sent from his house. And the very next day, I had asked his parents to come to our OP. And this is after 4 days. You saw the lesions have all passed through that inflammatory or infectious phase. It's a case of Kardama Visarpa. And this is another case of plantopalmar psoriasis with she is a diabetic patient, 56 years old, and ongoing treatment now still going on. And in 1.5 weeks, last Wednesday I had seen her, and last Wednesday this was the situation, and this is as of today. This is today's photo. Today, she had come to the OP after 10 days of treatment. Treatment is still going on. This is a case of Kaksha or a Kshudraroga that we know. A recurrent lesion. This, even a lot of steroid treatment were going on to that boy. And still the same site, same lesions were developing again and again, and our treatment had given this result with non-recurrence. He happens to be son of a staff of our college itself. This is a case of the seen on all the joints, on all the flexures joints. He is a 12-year-old boy, and he had taken antifungal and steroid intake at the same time, external application with the recurrence. And with our medicines, the case had totally relieved. This is a case of footwear dermatitis. with the pitta and kapha dominance, the single use of a new chappal that lady had developed. And this, the second photo, is by 2 weeks of treatment. This is a case of pustular psoriasis. And he was admitted before giving our Agada drugs. He was admitted, given Virechana. And then 1 month of Agada medicine was given in the line of Rasayana. This is the result. This is a case of Pitta Adhika Vata Rakta. The whole body is there. The lesion was all over the body. It's a case of psoriasis, but the diagnosis goes towards Pitta Adhika Vata Rakta. He visited our OP, and this is the lesion by 1 month. This is a case of multiple fracture, road traffic accident, and three times skin graft was done for this boy, thrice, but all with failure. Three times the skin grafting was a failure. So he came to our OP and got treatment. And in a duration of 1 month, with the non-recurrence, the wound had healed for 90%. And he is now, I think, he is working in a hospital as a therapist in somewhere in Malappuram. He joined actually because of our influence. He joined Ayurveda course, Ayurveda therapist. This is a case of RA, with RA factor more than 100, and C-reactive protein was 30 odd C-reactive proteins. She happens to be a teacher, a chemistry teacher from Tamil Nadu. You can see the maggots on the wound. And this was during the treatment. And this one at the time of discharge. But we had to discharge the patient on 23rd March 2020 because of that lockdown stress. We had that risk. We had to refer the patient. RA treatment is still going on through phone. Wound had completely healed by a duration of 10 days. This was the way that she had come with maggots. You can see the maggots on the first photo. The second one is at the phase of during the wound healing phase. And this one, the third photo, the medicine is there in that lesion. And on the fourth photo, this was the photo taken on the day of discharge on 23rd March 2020. We had to send her because of this. This is a case of Budgeri syndrome. Budgeri syndrome is a classical Garavisha line disorder. Classical Garavisha means as if text has been totally depicted in this patient. Every feature of Garavisha is there, including the Ojo Vikrita Lakshana. There is no time for theory. So I would skip off all the theoretical references. These are the photographs which we had taken during the course of treatment. Evidently psoriasis. If you see, there are veins engorged with hepatomegaly and splenomegaly with the esophageal varices. He had a history of 2 times hemoptysis, and also he has arches. He had recurrent fever. His bilirubin level were more than 12. His hemoglobin level was 6 point odd, near to 7. And this is what we had given him at the time of discharge. His ascites was totally relieved with the together with that hepatomegaly and splenomegaly. He had absolute control on his agni. Skin lesions had vanished. Now let us come to our area of interest of today's topic. If at all any doubt is there, please tell. And if time elapses, organizers, please tell when to stop, because I don't know how far I can concise this. Vilwadi Agada, I have deliberately mentioned it as Vilwadi Agada because whatever we get is a Vilwadi Bhutika, but there is a small difference between, because to be a Vilwadi Agada, it requires a lot of grinding, a lot of bhavana is required, and bhavana of at least a year is mentioned. But even though not for a year, I possess Vilwadi Bhutika, which is given bhavana for 3 months duration. Before starting this discussion, I would like to bring into your notice that to be an Agada clinician or to practice Agada yogas or our medicine, which is so called Agada, because I don't believe in specialization. Our text is not written in the pattern of specialization, because to write a prescription is to assess a samprapti properly, to come to a conclusion, to deduce our area, and to properly place the patient in a disease, because we cannot blindly tell that a case of psoriasis is sigma. It can land up in some other area if we properly evaluate the samprapti. So I don't believe in specialization. To write a yoga which is related to Agada Tantra or in the context of Agada, we need a few things. That is, we should prepare medicine by ourselves, or we should be able to procure the medicine from reliable source. That is the most important thing that we need. The drugs should be available. We should know what are all the drugs which are added to it. We should know the strength and weakness of our medicine which we are going to give to the patient. So blindly prescribing the market available medicine will not serve the purpose. That too, that time which we deserve. We think, right, we need to give a patient this much relief within this much days to keep him comfortable, to make us happy. This is what the end of the day every clinician likes. The patient should get relief and we should be happily returning to home. So we should have a proper source of collection of drug. At the same time, somebody should be there who is reliable, who can give us properly prepared medicines. Such a Vilvadi Agada is very effective. Kapavata Shamaka, Ruksha drug, a Tikshna drug, and its indication itself is suggestive of its area of prescription. Bhujangal Utondara Vrushtika Dehi, Visuchika Ajirna Garajvaraischa, Artha Naran Bhuta Vidarshitamscha, Swasti Karoti Anjana Panana Sehi. So all these lines suggest four or five areas where we can use Vilvadi Agada effectively. The first line is for a Vishachikitsaka, Bhujangaluta Unduru Vrishchika Dehi, Visuchika Ajirana Garajvaraischa is for a person who is a Kaya Chikitsa area or any other OP where the patient is having an Agni related disorder is the second line. Visuchika Ajirana Garajvaraischa Artha Naran Bhuta Vidarshitamscha is for a child, a Manasaroga treating person, or a Kaumara Vritya physician. All these areas include Vilvadi Agada, and that can't be denied, because we when diagnose a case as a Garavisha, even there are cases where I have used Vilvadi Agada for Nasya. In the case of a joint disorder which was autoimmune in nature, whom she had a depressive episodes, was treated with Vilvadi Agada to relieve from those pain. And also for children in autism, or in the case of that skin lesion, which I had shown that videography, if you remember that video, two videos, Vilvadi Gutika should be remembered. In such cases, Vilvadi Gutika in that line, or Vilvadi Gutika in autism sort of disorders. These much areas we can use Vilvadi, that too, Swasti Karoti, Anjana, Pana, and Nasya. So Vilvadi Gutika is written for Anjana, Pana, and Nasya. And one more thing which we have to interpret from the line is Susukshma Pishta is a word. So practical evaluation is also very essential in that Susukshma Pishta, because either we all know that it can get highly potensified, more the bhavana, more the potency. And also one more practical thing that we confront is, we use it for anjana. If there are pieces of drugs in it, now that can cause extra problem to the eyes also. So in that situation also, susukshma pishtatva is very, very essential. Practical point of view, the patient should not get any new complication because of a treating physician. So that is also another indication that we get while this concept of susukshma pishta is mentioned. Not the only thing that the potensification increases, it is getting more potensified. So in those areas, Tilvadiyagada is very helpful. And one more thing I would like to tell you is Vilvadi Gutika can be given in various doses. In that child who had developed that Visarpa, if you remember that video, I had given quarter tablet 4 times a day, quarter tablet 4 times a day on the first day so that he can get sensitized to the taste. And the dose was increased to half tablet 4 times a day. Half tablet 4 times a day. So multiple dosage of Vilvadiyagada is very, very effective at times, especially in the cases of Visuchika, Ajirna, the conditions where the children are passing loose stools or they are having pain abdomen. In such conditions, smaller dose of multiple dosage of Vilvadiyagada is giving a lot of result. And that too, I will come to another yoga which is very effective in vomiting, frequent vomiting in small children. Nowadays, with great confidence, we can manage this vomiting with these two combinations. One is Vilvadiyagada and another yoga. I will come to that particular yoga when we come to that page. Next yoga is Vishavilvadiyagada, a similar indication of Vilvadi Gutika. But extra ingredients added are Nilini Mula, Ishwara Mula, and Patha. And there is one more practice of adding Ashwagandha to it. See, the view, the vision of a clinician lies in this one more addition of Ashwagandha. I have put it in a bracket. This is a good rasayana. I need not explain more. Nilini Mula, Ishwara Mula, and Patha gives an added catalytic effect to the effect of Vilvadi Gutika. And if we add Ashwagandha, it acts as a very good rasayana. In a regulated dose, 1 OD or 1 BD dose for a prolonged usage with a single prescription. Vishavilvadi Gutika, only one medicine is enough. The patient is also happy. And we are also in a situation where we need not complicate the prescription or complicate the things. So indications are almost similar. And with the Vilvadi and Vishavilvadi, a third yoga is coming into the picture, which is not so common usage in Kerala, but in northern part of India, say in Maharashtra or in Andhra Pradesh, such area of practice, one more medicine, which is very, very similar in action to Vilvadi and Vishavilvadi is Sanjeevani Vati. I have not added it in the slide because I am not so common in using that Sanjeevani Vati because the desirable effect is available with the Vilvadi or Vishavilvadi itself. Eka Amajirna Gulmeshu, Dve Visuchyam Pradapayet, Tisrascha Sarpa Dashteshu, Chaturtaha Sannipatike. See the similarity with the indication. And what I have inferred from the practice of Sanjeevani Vati and the practice of Vilvadi Gutika is Sanjeevani Vati dosage is much more lesser, and we have to be very careful before prescribing Sanjeevani Vati. Because there is a concept in Agada prescription that Agadas can be divided into two. One is Savisha Agada and other is Nirvisha Agada. This Sanjeevani Vati can be added under Savisha Agada. So before prescribing, we have to be very confident that the condition is non-toxic in nature. There should not be an involvement of a bite or this one. To prescribe such a agada, there should be a confirmed history of bite, confirmed history of poison to prescribe a savisha agada, where one of the ingredient or one or more ingredients will be toxic in nature. But in other side, Vilvadi and Vishavilvadi is absolutely a safer choice for us to prescribe even for children in a similar condition. We don't know whether there is any toxin in that particular clinical condition. So I bank upon Vilvadi or Vishavilvadi rather than Sanjeevani Vati at times where there is an improper or incomplete history of involvement of toxin in that particular case. But both have similar indication. Visuchika is a pain predominant condition, and Ajirna Samprapti, where a textual reference, if we need a textual reference, Charaka, Vimanasthana, second chapter, there is one reference called dvividam cha idam kama pradoshaje vikaram achakshate bhishajaha. That particular reference is a call for a physician to prescribe vishavilvadiyagada or vilvadiyagada. And if we see the features of alasaka and visuchika, the dosha predominance, there our hand will naturally go towards vilvadivati. That is the samprapti where we can prescribe the second line of vilvadigutika. The samprapti lies in charaka vimanasthana second chapter. And another reference that is probably a positive reference for Bilwadi or Vishavilwadi is in Jwara Chikitsa. In Jwara Chikitsa, I probably it is the shloka number 180 or so, where Abhishangaja Jwara is mentioned. Abhishangaja Jwara, the treatment mentioned in Charaka Samhita is Visha Chikitsa is the treatment there. What Charaka mentions is Vishagna Eva. Vishagna is the treatment that we have to apply there. There, Vilvadi Kutika is the choice. Or Visha Vilvadi Kutika is the choice. Next is Jivaraksha Kutika. Jivaraksha Kutika is mentioned in Prayoga Samuchaya. Prayoga Samuchaya, it's a Malayalam textbook. I shall share the slides. Those who are not able to follow Malayalam, these are the ingredients. And Jivaraksha Kutika is the first line of treatment in a condition where there is confirmed visha in it. In the samprapti, there is a confirmed history of visha in it. So, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. It's a first line of defense for a visha chikitsa practitioner in a case of sarpa visha, and a wonderful rasayana yoga if it is practiced in a regulated dose, and the drugs which are visha in nature are properly shodhita in nature. It can be an excellent rasayana. Now, the four or five cases which we had discussed earlier, the case of Darvikara visha, the first case, the second case Mandali visha, and that Luta visha. In all these three cases, Jivaraksha Gutika was given in one BD dose with the Kshira as Anupana, with the proper pathya. Proper pathya in the sense, no lavana was advised to her. Even salt or coffee or tea, nothing was suggested for all these three patients for a duration of 1 week. They were given podiyari kanni. Podiyari kanni is rice kanji preparation. And other than that, only boiled vegetables with a little bit of shunti churna, at the same time haridra was given, and nothing else, not even salt, while prescribing his Jivaraksha Gutika for 1 week. 1 week duration, they were taken care of, just like a case of sarpa visha, and then the prescription was changed. What I would like to convey when in Jivaraksha Gutika is, it's an excellent first line of defense, and it is an excellent first line of defense for a non a long-standing illness or a non-healing conditions like diabetic ulcers or diabetic gangrene. In such conditions, we can definitely use. I have old managed cases. As time will not permit, only the specific cases I have put today. Jivaraksha Gutika, I have tried with four or five non-healing ulcers or diabetic cases, diabetic gangrene. We could successfully save the fingers from getting amputated. That amputation procedure itself, we had prevented for four or five cases with the help of only this drug and an erythylum. Nothing else was given to the patient. With erythylum and proper bandaging, proper caring, Jivaraksha Gutika was prescribed with the absolute pathyam. So it's a first line of defense. And it is a wonderful rasayana given at a regulated dose, half tablet OD with the milk for 1 month. Now remember that case of pustular psoriasis, which we had discussed earlier. This case, pustular psoriasis, there was pus oozing out with an offensive smell on his hand as well as on the feet. And Jivaraksha, 1 month, had given this result with non-recurrence. He had brought four or five psoriasis cases to our OP later. He is a government employee. working in a court. And this boy also, 1 week Jeevaraksha Gutika was given. Jeevaraksha Gutika was given. And this lady, another yoga, not for her. These are the area. If we go through its dosha shamakatva, for Visha, it will be a challenge or it will be a daring step to assess dosha shamakatva. But still, as per the Charaka Sutrasthana 19th chapter, where he mentions, in an agantuja condition, there is an invariable involvement of nija dosha. Without the involvement of nija dosha, an agantuja vikara cannot take a proper course of a disorder. That is what Charaka in his 19th chapter, Vidya Shloka and Chakrapani, authoritatively mentions. Nija dosho asti eva is the Chakrapani's word. So, believing in that reference, this Jeevaraksha Gutika is more of vata kapha shamakatva in nature, but in case of an emergency, we can prescribe Jeevaraksha Gutika with great confidence, but not for children. But not for children. For children, we have another option for us, which is equally effective as Jeevaraksha Gutika, and it is a Nirvisha Agada. We will come to that. This is another yoga, Taruna Bhaskara Gutika. Before going to that, I would like to bring your notice to these names. Jeeva Raksha Gutika, which is really in that name itself, we can get an indication. And this is a second line of defense of a physician who is treating a Sarpavisha or who is treating an autoimmune disorder, where a patient has to get a proper recovery from an illness after a proper Shodhana. Taruna Bhaskara is a rising sun in its rising phase. Taruna Bhaskara. This is absolutely an indication of the yoga which we can give to a patient who has recovered from an acute illness and is having stability as far as his illness is concerned, and a physician has got a proper grip over the illness, and we can further try for another yoga which is a rasayana and which is mentioned in the context of Visha. And such conditions are usually, I would like to name the condition, two conditions which we have tried in our OP is multiple sclerosis, and at the same time we had tried with a few cases of MND. And multiple sclerosis, two patients are still under follow up with this single yoga, Taruna Bhaskara Gutika, and also Brahmi Drakshadi Kashaya. It is Brahmi Drakshadi Kashaya is yoga mentioned in Sahasra Yoga Jwaradhikara. Jwaradhikara, Sahasra Yoga, Brahmi Drakshadi Kashaya, and Taruna Bhaskara Gutika. A person who was bedridden, he is an entrepreneur, and he takes he gives motivational talk. He is residing in Tirur. And he is still under treatment. For the past 2 or 3 months, he is not coming because of this corona issue. And somehow he is managing this Taruna Bhaskara Gutika right from my Guruji. He is preparing medicine and he is applying. Taruna Bhaskara Gutika is such a yoga where a patient who has been stabilized with our initial management, and whatever the condition may be, the second line of medicine we cannot an apt prescription will be Taruna Bhaskara Gutika. And if you see this Pittadhika Vata Rakta case, this one, Taruna Bhaskara was the choice which was given after a course of Kottam Tagaradi Kashayam. We will come to that. After a course of Kottam Tagaradi Kashayam and Gopi Chandanadi Gutika. Gopi Chandanadi Gutika is not related to Agada, so we need not explain about that. Kottam Tagaradi Kashayam is mentioned in Prayoga Samuchaya. I have that ingredients. We will come to that point. Once that Pitta and Ama condition in that patient was subsided, we tried with Taruna Bhaskara Gutika. Taruna Bhaskara Gutika for a period of 1.5 months. 1 month, this was the phase. We had asked him to continue the medicine for 15 more days at a dose of 1 BD before food with proper Pathya. And another case of Taruna Bhaskara was that cobra bite after Jeevaraksha Gutika, this one, this patient. After Jeevaraksha Gutika, we had given Taruna Bhaskara Agada together with the Kottam Tagaradi Kashayam internally and for Parisheka. This is the indication that we can provide to the patient once the risky situation has passed off. This is a, yes. This is another yoga, Pavitra Vatakam, which can be placed as a tertiary or a fourth or fifth choice in a case of poison, or it is a Vamaka Vishahara yoga. In a single word, we can tell it's a Vamaka Vishahara yoga. Pavitra Vatakam, one or two tablets in a single stat dose can induce vomiting. It induces vomiting. So we cannot, even though the indication is mentioned in Visha, mentioned together with this Jivaraksha Gutika, Taruna Bhaskara Gutika, and Pavitra Vatakam are mentioned in the same chapter, the area of its action is widely differing. It is unlikely a yoga which we discuss like Jivaraksha or Taruna Bhaskara. Pavitra Vatakam is a yoga which is Vamaka in nature. So wherever we feel like there is Prabhuta Kapha in the patient and the case is toxic in nature, a toxic situation is running in the patient because of that Ama Visha, where I mentioned this Ama Visha in Vimanasthana second chapter, or in a case of Dushi Visha, where Kapha Vrto Varsha Gananu Bandhi Samprapti is running on in the patient's samprapti, that particular disorder, where we need to give vamana, one tablet of Pavitra Vatakam will be sufficient. To stop Pavitra Vatakam induced vamana, there is one yoga in Prayoga Samuchayam that we will discuss. Then that particular yoga I have started giving in almost all the cases where there is vomiting because of food poisoning. Without Pavitra Vatakam, that single yoga has helped me a lot, especially in children. That will come to the discussion, and this is yoga which we can practice. Every medicine is prepared in a similar way. There is only a small difference in preparation of Jivaraksha Gutika. If time permits, I will tell how Jivaraksha Gutika differs in its preparation. That at the end of the session, please do remember me, so that if I forget, please remind me. And next yoga is Murwari. Murwari is in a single word, Visha Amaharatva action can be attained through Murwadi Gutika. In almost 50% of the photographs which I had shown you, this Murwadi was given in a dose of 2 TID with hot water for Amapachana. Murwadi Gutika and Tripala Kwata were given for Amapachana Anulomana effect by keeping in mind that it is a Gara disorder. And Murwadi's indication is also very, very specific. Gara Upahata Pavakaha. And note, again, I will repeat that word, Gara Upahata Pavakaha. That is Agni, which is vitiated because of Gara. So Gara is not the area of interest. Agni is the area of interest in the cases of Gara, which we diagnose with properly evaluating, properly taking the history of a case. If you see the Ashtanga Hridaya Uttara Tantra, the features, and you suspect there is Prabhuta involvement of Ama in that patient, Murwadi will be a choice. And it's mentioned in a Churna Yoga, but I, because of the palatable issue and for that preservation issue, I'm preparing tablet of it with the nearly 1 gram of weight, 1 gram tablet. So 2 TID is the dose which is given with hot water. 50% of the case, this teacher was given, and this lady was given Murwadi Gutika, and he was given Murwadi Gutika, and almost all the cases which this lady, Jivaraksha with Murwadi was given, I think, in the initial phase. So Murwadi is almost, what to say, it's recorded in my practice. I use a lot of in lot of patients where I get a confirmed history of Gara. So one thing we'll slightly deviate from the topic. That is, why we have such an importance in prescribing the Gara Yogas is, if we see Ashtanga Hridaya, the context of Gara, Tena Pandu, the reference goes as Tena Pandu, Krisha, Alpa, Agni, Kasa, Shwasa, Jwaradhitaha, Vayuna, Pratilomena, Swapna Chintaparan. There are cluster of symptoms mentioned in that single Gara perspective. So instead of thinking whether there is Gara in the patient, so it is a duty of we physicians to interpret the reference in a different way. A patient who is presented with Pandu, Tarsya, Alpagni, Tasa, Shwasa, Jwara, Vayuna Pratilomena, that is Udavarta, Swapna Chinta Parayanaha, depressed, stressed, Mahodara, a patient presented with ascites or hepatosplenomegaly, Mahodara, Yakrit, Kliha, Dinavak, Durbalo, Alasaha, all are the involvement of Ojas. Ojas, Vikrita Lakshana, if you see, these features are very evident. The similar features are mentioned in that context of Gara also. So, a patient may not come to you with Gara. He may be presenting to us with Pandu, with Karshya, with any of these features as a single presenting complaint. Now, it is our duty to evaluate by taking a proper history that whether there is any history of Visha in him or not. Similarly, Dushi Visha. So it is our duty to evaluate whether there are any features, any his presenting complaints are any way related to the Visha or not, or else we will be definitely mistaken and our prescription may go wrong. A classical example that we can get is in Panduroga. If you see Panduroga, there are two yogas. After this, after the class, kindly refer that two yogas. One is Kautaja Tripala. And another yoga is just above that. There is another yoga. It is Yoga Raja Churna. It is not Yoga Raja Gugulal. Yoga Raja Churna is the name of that yoga in Charaka Samhita. Two yogas are mentioned one after the other in Panduroga Chikitsa Charaka Samhita. You just see those two yogas and immediately see the features of Gara Visha mentioned in Ashtanga Hridaya. You'll be surprised to see that all these three references are one and the same. The indications of this Kautaja Tripala, the indication of Yoga Raja Churna, and the features of this one, Gara Visha. And also, another yoga is there. It is Sharagutika. Sharagutika mentioned in Charaka Samhita Chikitsa Sana 23rd chapter. If you see the indications of Sharagutika, it is exactly similar to the whole shloka of Gara Visha. See how a yoga is formulated, how a yoga is designed, how a disease samprapti is intimately related to the indications. The whole indication is one single spectrum. Okay, coming back to the topic, Murvadhyagada is an initial yoga for Amapachana. Another is Dushi Vishari. Now, Dushi Vishari is a yoga which we should give as a rasayana, because the yoga suggests that Dushi Visharto Susvinna Urdhva Adha Shodita Dushi Vishari Magadam Lehet Madhuna Plutam. So it should be given with Madhu. It should be given after Shodhana. Then only it can act as a rasayana, as the yoga is. It is not only a Shamana Yoga, it is a Rasayana Yoga also. So, it is better for our practice, for the success of the patient, for a proper action of Dushi Vishari Agada, that we should prescribe Dushi Vishari Agada for a Shodhita patient, and that too, a condition which is recurrently seen in a patient. A patient may come to us with a classical feature that its waxing and waning of features can be, the patient may characteristically tell. He may tell that if this comes, especially in the rainy season, or during the rainy, or in the summer season, or in the warm climate, or whenever he gets exposed to a factor A or B or C. So whenever he is having an exposure to a particular condition, we can diagnose it as a condition of Dushi Visha, and we have to suggest a proper diet. We have to undergo a virechana in him, even though not possibly a classical virechana, at least we should do a namapachana. We should give a smaller yoga which can act as analomana in nature with a proper pathya, then only prescribe dushi vishari agada. It will be best prescribed in such conditions. It's available, dushi vishari is available, or else we can prepare also. Dashangam gutika. Dashangam gutika was given for pitta predominant kleda samyukta cases where we see immediate onset of features. This is one case. I hope the slides are changing properly to my speed. This is one case. And this is another case. And surprisingly, Dashangam Gutika and Bilwadi Gutika were given to this boy for 1 week with a half tablet, 4 times a day, without an external application of a medicine. A single medicine was not even given for external application. Just by internal administration, see the change. Dashangam Gutika and Bilwadi Gutika were given half tablet, 4 times a day. This is the indication for Dashangam Gutika. And Dashangam Gutika is also an effective drug in the cases of post-herpetic neuralgia pattern pain, where pitta might have acted in the samprapti and we have managed it effectively and there is a residual pathology which is remaining even after the management. In such conditions, Dashangam Gutika acts very good. And together with that, I usually prescribe Neeli Tulasi Adi Kashaya. So this is the area. The first and foremost thing that we can think when we think of Dashangam Gutika is these much areas. And in acute infectious conditions of Urdhva Jatrugata Vikaras also, Dashangam Gutika helps a lot. Dashangam Gutika with another yoga is there, I will tell. Amukkura Vayambadi Kashayam. There is another yoga called Amukkura Vayambadi Kashayam with the Dashangam Gutika. And that is very effective in the cases of acute infectious conditions in Urdhva Jatrugata Vikaras. Hingwadi Gutika is the drug which can be replaced to Jivaraksha Gutika in the cases of children. Now, it is a Nirvishagada. You see the ingredients, Hingu, Ashwagandha, Saindhava Lavana, and Erimakattam Charanagam is meconium of the calf of a buffalo, Sadhyojata calf. Pippali, Maricha and Shunti and Arkakshira. It's a very effective drug which we can give for children also, and it's a replacement drug for Jivaraksha Gutika in the cases of acute illness which is seen in children. And once the risk situation has passed, now we are talking about children, and a replacement for Taruna Bhaskara Gutika is, sorry, Taruna Bhaskara Gutika is, there is another yoga, it's not in the slide, Garalagna Rasayana, there is another yoga called the Garalagna Rasayana. If time permits, we'll discuss about that. That is the replacement drug for children instead of prescribing Taruna Bhaskara Gutika. So, see, the text has the beauty. Only thing is that we should be able to interpret the things out of it. Jivaraksha, for children, we can think of Hingwadi Gutika. Taruna Bhaskaram, if the condition, similar condition arises in children, we can think of Garalagna Rasayana. It's a very good Shwasahara drug and also very effective in the cases of Vata Vyadi diagnosis in children. Any Vata Vyadi, it's not a diagnosis. I broadly mentioned that particular name. Neeli Tulasi Adi Kashaya, as we all know, the drug is extensively practiced everywhere, but the Kashaya Yoga, Taila Yoga and Girata Yoga, all the three formats are available with a minute change. Neeli Daladi may be the name. Neeli Tulasi Adi Kashaya is available, which can be given in the conditions of Kleda, Samyukta conditions, and Taila can be given in a risk factor has been crossed in that patient. We have managed it with the Kleda Shoshana drug, Vishahara drug. The next line of management is Taila. And Neeli Daladi Grita is a very good rasayana. Neeli Daladi Grita is a very good rasayana. So these areas decide the yoga which we have to select out of this Neeli Tulasi Adi. And Neeli Tulasi Adi, even though it is mentioned in the conditions of Luta Visha, when we think of Luther, we have two choices. One is Nili Tulasi Adi and another is Lodra Seviyadi Kashaya. Lodra Seviyadi is more Kleda Shoshana in nature, Pitta Kapashamana in nature, while Nili Tulasi Adi is more Vata Kapashamana in nature, and slow acting drug when we compare to Lodra Seviyadi. Why I am telling this? Because Nili Tulasi Adi, in my OP practice, limited OP practice, I prefer, with a diagnosis I will tell, now the interpretation is left to the physicians. Nili Tulasi Adi Kashaya is effective in the cases of Kapha-Vata dominant presentations of a Luta-Visha condition or a condition of a skin disorder where post-herpetic neuralgia sort of disorders, Nili Tulasi Adi can come to our help. And Nili Tulasi Adi is also effective in the conditions once the Kleda has crossed. Lodra Seviyadi is a yoga which is Pitta Kapha Shamana in nature. It is Ruksha in, it is a bit Ruksha, a bit mild in nature when compared to other Tikshna drugs in Visha. And it is also effective in a cases of pemphigus pattern diagnosed conditions. Kardama Visarpa sort of diagnosis or a condition where there is acute manifestation of Kleda in a patient and it is Pitta Kapha dominant. There is smell coming from the lesion and there is oozing of pus or serous discharge. Think of Lodra Seviyadi or else think of Nili Tulasi Adi. This is the demarcation that we can bring when we think of Nili Tulasi Adi and Lodra Seviyadi Kashaya. Another yoga is Koshataki Adi Yavagu. Koshataki Adi Yavagu is a beautiful yoga where its preparation can be easily misinterpreted as a powder boiled with rice, or a kanni is to be prepared with Koshataki Adi, and it can be more effective if it is prepared as a Kashaya yoga. Koshataki Adi Kashaya has to be prepared, then rice has to be cooked with that Kashaya, then it becomes a proper Yavagu formulation and it can be given in the condition of Vegantara, is the word which is mentioned. Now it's a very big topic of interest which is worth talking for 1 hour, because Vega is not only pertaining to Visha. Vegantara is not only the interest of a Visha Chikitsa practitioner, because we can get this word of Vega in Jwara, in Vata Vyadhi, in Chardi, in Bahirayama, and in Unmada, and in Apasmara. See, that one Vega is mentioned in this much chapters of Charaka Samhita. And if a yoga, an Acharya has mentioned as Yung Jyat Vegantare, is a debatable issue, is an interesting area where we have a lot of areas to discuss. When to give in Jwara, when to give in Apasmara, when to give in Bahirayama, when to give in Chardi. And when we discuss about Chardi, whether it can be indicated in Vamana as a therapy, therapeutical Vamana procedure for a patient, if we prefer to give a yoga as a Peyadi, Tarpanadikrama, Koshataki Yavagu, whether it is a choice or not, is an interesting area to discuss. Now, I am leaving for the participants. We can think or debate about this issue. So not only skin disorder, other areas also, Yavagu, Koshataki Yavagu, Koshataki Yavagu can be extended. Right. Next, Punaravartaka Jwarahara Kashaya. Even though it is not mentioned in the area of Visha, it is mentioned in Jwara. And that too, Punaravartana of a Jwara. Punaravartana is a classical area where Dushi Visha is an option for us to think. And in a Dushi Visha, there is Kaphavarana, there is involvement of Tridosha, there is a necessity of Shodhana, there is a necessity of recovery of a patient without giving a Tikshna treatment. Punaravartaka Jwarahara Kashaya is a wonderful yoga when we think of these four photos. One is this area, I have not given to him. In such conditions, I have not given that yoga in this patient, but this is an area, potential area, and for this lady. In such kleda samyukta recurrent conditions of a skin disorder where there is shota or all the features of inflammation are seen with the lymphedema, with the fever, the patient can be prescribed with punaravartaka jwara rakshaya as a first prescription. And this boy, I had given, we have not discussed what medicines we had given to this Visarpa boy who got result in 4 days. This was taken on day 1 and this video is taken on day 4. Today afternoon they had sent me this video. And see the 4 days difference. Punaravartaka jwarahara kashaya was given in BD dose and kottam tagaradi kashayam was given for pana jala. Only 2 prescriptions were given to this boy. Punaravartaka jwarahara kashaya was given for twice daily for virechana itself. He has been passing 7 to 8 times stools in a single day. Still I told okay, carry on with that, give proper patya. And kottam tagaradi kashayam was given for pana jala. This is what punaravartaka jwara can do in a patient. And this is not the only boy. For every such visarpas, such condition which is seen all over the body, we can think of punaravartaka jwarahara kashaya. In such pus oozing conditions, sudden onset conditions, punaravartaka jwarahara kashaya, at the same time it can act as virechana yoga. That's why punaravartaka is a very good choice when we think of practicing. Because if you see punaravartaka, the concept of punaravartaka jwara in Charaka Samhita Chikitsa Sthana 3rd chapter, jwaram vyavartate punaha is the word of beginning. That ojas, visha, the conditions of skin, the conditions of recurrent joint involvement, the area of vatarakta, the area of kushta, the area of santarpanotta vikara, every condition is mentioned in the context of punaravartaka jwara. The explanation of punaravartaka jwara is a wonderful area. If you see that, refer that yoga, you can interpret the clinical conditions where we can give even in the cases of visha also. That's why I have mentioned this yoga. Amukura Vayambadi Kashayam, I already told, Amukura Vayambadi Kashayam is a Vata Tapahara yoga. All the drugs are available. Ashwagandha, Vacha, Chandana, Katuka, Rohini, Trikatu, and Ishwaramula. All the yogas are available, all the drugs are available. And the classical indication of this yoga is the explanation. The last line of reference is very worth noting. It should be given in the evening hours with the jiraka as a prakshepaka dravya is the indication of Amukura Vayambadi Kashayam. Amukura is Ashwagandha, Vacha is Vayambu. So Amukura, Ashwagandha, Vacha, Chandana, Katuga, Rohini, Trikatu and Ishwaramula. It is a very, very effective Vata Kapha Shamaka yoga. And in initial phase itself, if the patient is having an inflammatory condition or a Samavastha Yukta Vata Rakta conditions are there in a patient, we can think of Amukura Vayambadi Kashaya. Vata Kapha Shamana yoga. Now, this is another yoga, Musta Ramachari Kashayam. All these are there in a single chapter, Prayoga Samuchayam, Panchama Paricheda. It's a Malayalam textbook. I have translated the ingredients. Those who are not following the Malayalam, please see. I can share the slide also to the organizers. Musta Ramachari Kashayam is mentioned in Panchama Paricheda. This is also a Vata Kapahara yoga, but a classical difference is this one, Amukura Vayambadi, is Vata Pradhana Kapha Anubandha conditions are the indication of this yoga, but this one, Kapha predominant Vata Anubandha condition. So, if we think of such condition, you think of Kushta. Now, our area of interest is only skin disorders here. And next, we can go to the joint also. Musta Ramachari Kashayam, I have given for a case of psoriasis with the Kapha predominant features and Vata Anubandha feature, and also a patient who is fed up of taking medicine or whether there is any depression pathology running together with the condition. If you see, Sarpaganda is one of the yoga. So it is the duty of a Vishajikitsaka or a reader to assess wherever there is mentioning of Sarpaganda in a Vishahara yoga, it means there is an indication, there is a scope for a physician to prescribe a patient who is having a depression also together with that. I have prescribed for 3 or 4 cases recently, Musta Ramachari Kashan in a psoriatic patient who is having lack of sleep, who is depressed in one way or the other, who is having a pathology of in Garavisha, if you see that second line, Vayuna Pratilomena Sopna Chinta Parayanaha, that Sopna Chinta Parayanaha pathology, if we get a history of that word in a case of a kapha condition where Vata is Anubandha, think of Musta Ramachari Kashayam. 2 or 3 weeks, the lesion will subside, the patient will be better. I won't claim that he will be comfortable free of symptoms, but he will have a considerable difference in his symptoms. At the same time, his stress level will be much more improved. So that will be sufficient for a stress relieving mechanism if we provide to the patient. His skin condition also will be much better after 3 weeks of giving this Musta Ramachari. One yoga will be sufficient. Musta Ramachari together with Murvadi Vati. Finish. Our prescription is over. No need for thinking a third medicine. If I am running short of time, kindly please tell. This is Kottam Thakaradi Kashaya, Yashti, Thakara, Pushta, Chandana, Ushira, and Sariva. These are the 3 conditions. And this is a Vata Pitta Shamana Yoga, Vata Pitta Hara Yoga. I am extensively using in my OP, Kottam Thakaradi Kashaya, for almost all the cases where Pitta is predominant and there is no oozing. So Vata Pitta condition. In a single word, the Samprapti, if we want to assess, think of Charaka Sutrasthana 17th chapter, Ashayapakarsha Samprapti, where Vata is the culprit and Pitta is the evident factor in such Samprapti. So in such skin or joint or any other condition, clinical conditions where this Samprapti fits to the patient, think of Kottam Thakaradi Kashayam. It's a wonderful yoga, only 6 yogas. Chandana, if not available, I use Rakta Chandana half the dose, half the quantity of Rakta Chandana because of non-availability of Chandana many times. Yashti, Thakara, Pushta, Chandana, Ushira. It can be easily prescribed in our practice also. This is a yoga where Nalpamaram Kashayam is given internally. I may need 1 or 2 minutes to explain because this is Nalpamara yoga. We need not go for that. Indications are almost similar. This Nalpamaram, Pata Udumbara Ashwatha and Plaksha combination is highly effective in the conditions of avascular necrosis of hip. 7 documented cases are there where after giving Nalpamaram Kashayam and Gubgulu Tiktaka Taila internally, the results have been encouraging. This Nalpamaram Kashayam together with the Gukula Tiktaka Taila after an initial Pachana. Amavachana. Amavachana was done with the Amrutottara Kashaya. So then later on, this Nalpamaram Kashayam mentioned in this Kashaya Yoga, Kshirapaka was not prepared. Kshirapaka stage should be given once that total Ama Nirharana is done. And one more area where Nalpamaram Kashayam is effective is the shloka, which is this one. The last shloka, Kshirena Kshiri Vrikshanam Kashayam Sasitam Kanam. This single line is highly effective in nasal bleeding also. I have tried with this Nalpamaram Kshirapaka for Pana internally with the Muhur dose, one day dose, some 180 ml to 200 ml was given for Pana. This one, Kshirena Kshiri Vrikshanam Kashayam. Kshirapaka is the yoga where we have to use Nalpamaram. These are the 2 indications where we can think of. in a case of again the samprapti is left to you, I would like to put one opinion in front of you. The area where the dhatu poshana krama is lacking, dhatu poshana krama from mamsa to medha, medha to asti, asti to majja is being affected. My perspective is on a yoga which is similar to this nalpamara or very much kashaya tikta in nature can come to our help, especially in the cases of degenerative condition. We can think of kshira paka of such condition. That was the concept which I had used in management of avascular necrosis of hip. Seven cases are there which still managing effectively. One is a police person also. He has started going to work. And one more yoga which I had used for externally was in those seven cases was upilu. Upilu twak kshirapaka was prepared. This karaskara kshiraparisheka was done in those patients. Karaskara kshiraparisheka. Lotus aviary we discussed. Nimba nilavakari, I think everybody is very familiar to that yoga. Nimba nilavakari is from Trivandrum Ayurveda College Pharmacopoeia Yoga, a very effective drug in kapha predominant vata conditions of psoriasis for anulomana purpose. What if swelling and pain comes to our OP? Shikru Punarnavadi is a choice. And Arkapatra Sveda is very effective in the cases of inflammatory monoarthritis sort of conditions. Inflammatory monoarthritis, it's 9:17. It's 9:17 time. If I want to stop, please tell. There are three more slides. That's all. Shall I stop here?
No, you can continue.
Yes. If it is interesting.
Yes, sir.
What if swelling and pain is presenting to us? Chikrupanamari obviously is a choice where there is kapha predominant swelling in a patient. Arkapatra Sveda in Sarpavisha Chikitsa, but the procedure is very simple. What we have to follow is 8 to 10 leaves of Arkapatra kept one above the other, roll it, tie it on the first quarter and third quarter, and cut it into equal halves. So we get two bundles of Arkapatra, and a little bit of ghee is to be smeared to an iron vessel and mildly heat this Arkapatra and keep on the swelling side. Even in the cases of snake bite, Arkapatra Sveda comes to the help. That cobra bite, if you remember, we had advised for the swelling and pain that she was having. She tried only one day, she had used that Arkapatra Sveda, the pain and swelling had come down. That much reliability is there on that drug. Arkapatra, Shweta Arkapatra or whatever, which is available in that context, because the availability of drug or another practitioner is worth discussing for 1 or 2 hours. Keep it aside. Arkapatra, 8 or 10, kept one above the other, rolled, tied on the first quarter and third quarter, cut it into two equal halves, and then do the Svedana accordingly. And another Trimurti Yoga, there is the specific word is mentioned for that. Trimurti Prayoga, Nimba, Neeli, and Karanja. Nimba Twak, Neelini Twak, and Karanjatwak. Neelini, the whole plant can be taken. Samula can be taken. Nimba, Karanjatwak, and Neelini Panchanga. It's a very effective yoga in the cases of varicosity, pain, swelling. Kashaya internally, at the same time, Parisheka. 1 week of this yoga has given a lot of help in my OP. Nimba, Neelini and Karanja. If Neelini is not available, only Karanja and Nimba will be sufficient. In that teacher, Megots, if you remember, Arya case, she was given Nimba and Karanja Parisheka whole body to manage the pain together with the management of ulcer. If you remember, she was having RA with a raised CRP and RA level was very high. So this yoga, Nimba, Neelini and Karanja, comes to help in such conditions, in Ama or Kapha Vata predominant condition. Erithaila is another yoga. It was my study drug. And Grita Saindava Parisheka is also very, very effective. And Dattura, Palasena, Grita and Saindava, slightly warm, and then use it as Parisheka. Shikru Punarnavadi Yoga, everybody knows. And in the case of cellulitis, I have already discussed about all these yogas. Nalpamaram, we discussed, Neeli Tulasyadi, Mustaramachadi, Kottam Thagaradi, and this vomiting case. And one yoga we will discuss now, because time is elapsing, this Dhanyaka, Bilva, Jiraka and Sita Prayoga. Dhanyaka, Bilva, Jiraka and Sita Prayoga. Dhanyaka, Bilva and Jiraka are to be heated in a dry iron vessel. Once it gets heated, turn off the flame and then add 2 tender coconut water. 2 tender coconut water and keep it for 1 hour. Then crush it very well, grind it very well, and then filter it and give in a moho moho dose. Almost all the cases where vamana or where chardi was a symptom or chardi was a condition, disease or a symptom, were managed, even for small children. In children, this is a very, very useful yoga. Dhanyaka, without powdering it, dhanyaka, crushed dhanyaka, or as such, dhanyaka as such, bilva, moola, crushed, jiraka, as such, heated. Once it gets slightly heated, turn off the flame, and to that heated vessel itself, put 2 tender coconut water, close, keep it closed. After 1 hour, crush it very well, and then filter it, give in more moho dose. 1 or 2 days will be enough to stop the vomiting. In adult patients, Laja Chandana Kshira Lepa is also effective. Laja Chandana Kshira, all these start to be grinded and made into a paste and applied over the neck. And also, I have tried with these 2 yogas. Bhumi Amalaka Prayoga is another prayoga which I had tried. No, not necessary. Dhanyaka, Bilva and Jiraka will be sufficient for our suddenly if vomiting arises and we want to stop it, and provided the condition should not be acute pancreatitis or acute emergency surgical condition, discretion should be kept in a case of acute pancreatitis or in a case of some other GI pathology which needs an emergency care. Better not to try with this and gamble. In other condition where we suspect food poisoning or ajirana and vomiting, not stopping, the patient is very much tired or dehydrating, this can be tried very, very effectively. Dhanyaka, Bilva and Jiraka Prayoga. And urine retention, tried n number of times, Kushmanda and Ela. Kushmanda Kanda, its stem should be used. It should be crushed. Say 20 grams of Kushmanda, crushed stem, not leaves. It should be taken, and 2 ela, ela complete, 2 fruit ela should be taken. It should be peeled off. Its seed should be crushed and then mixed together, and kashaya should be, chaturthava shesha kashaya should be prepared, and then sita should be added to it and given more moho. Urine retention will be subsided. And the another yoga, next yoga which we discussed, which we saw, pippali, ela and koshna, both mala and mutra retention, this can be tried. This has been tried for pana and parisheka. Pippali, ela, koshna jala, pana and parisheka were tried in pakshagata patient where constipation and stranguri were there. Pippali, ela with koshna jala was tried for parisheka, at the same time for pana. We had found relief in a 1 or 2 days of prayoga had come to this normalcy in the case of retention. Now for bleeding, we already discussed. For nasal bleeding also, Kshira Paka was used, and my most favorite drug which I practice is Lajjalu Kshira Paka. Lajjalu Kshira Paka has come to my help many times together with this Nalpamayam Palkashayam. And for Nasya and Anjana, in acute condition, we will not discuss this. These are the formulations which I use in my OP. Kashaya powder I have not added. For tablets, look, these are. And these are the areas where we can think of Agada practice in our routine clinical practice. Hridayavarana concept in preventive cardiology, Samyogaja or Garavisha and Dushivisha concept in the case of drug interaction and adverse drug reaction conditions, Dushivisha in drug resistant conditions, Viruddha in acute GI manifestations and non-communicable diseases and lifestyle disorders, and Garavish and Viruta in the conditions of genetic disorders and food poisoning. These are the areas of interest for a researcher to have more reference, more reading. I think we can reach up to this level in one hour 15 minutes. I have taken 1 hour 15 minutes, I think, to conclude. Ananta param kila shabda shastram, swalpam tatha yuhu bahavashya vignaha, grahyam tatha param apasya phalguhu, hamsam yatha shiram yuvambu madhyat. So we have a very less time, just like the concept that hamsa is capable of taking in, absorbing only, sucking in only kshira from a combination of kshira and water. So it is we practitioners who have to take only milk for our effective practice. And once we return to our home, let us be very happy after our practice. This is what every practitioner likes, right? Again, to conclude, one more statement I would like to tell is, as much as possible, if we prepare the medicines which we discussed by ourselves, or we have a proper reliable source, now we can do wonders in our practice. So with all my respect to the teachers who have been a very good guidance to me for all these years, I am concluding. Over to the organizers.
Hello, Achu.
Teacher.
During my initial presentation, starting itself, I had mentioned about my favorite teacher. Manju teacher is today with me. Namaste, madam. We could not talk in the initial phase. I think mute it under teacher.
Unmute it, ma'am.
Unmute it, yeah, teacher. Unmute it. Yes.
Okay. Kekamo. വളരെ ഞാൻ ഇത് മൊത്തം ടോക്കും കേട്ടു. നമ്മുടെ ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റിൽ തന്നെ ഉണ്ടാക്കിയ ഒരു 80% യോഗങ്ങളെ കുറിച്ചാണ് ഗോപി ഇപ്പൊ സംസാരിച്ചത്. കേക്കാമോ? ഹലോ,
ഹലോ,
കേക്കാമോ? അപ്പൊ ശരിക്കും നിദാന പഞ്ചകങ്ങളെ വെച്ച് ഗോപി പറഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്ന ഈ ട്രീറ്റ്മെന്റ് ലെവല് വളരെ ഇൻഫർമേറ്റീവ് ആയിരുന്നെന്നാണ് ഞാൻ മനസ്സിലാക്കുന്നത്. അതുപോലെ ഇത് കേട്ട എല്ലാ ഡോക്ടർമാർക്കും വളരെ ഇൻഫർമേറ്റീവ് ആയിരുന്നിരിക്കണം. ഇതിനകത്ത് ജീവരക്ഷ, തരുണ ഭാസ്കരം, വില്വാദി, വിഷവില്വാദി, മൂർവാദി, ഇതെല്ലാം മിക്കവാറും ഉള്ള യോഗങ്ങളെല്ലാം അവസാനം പറഞ്ഞ കുറച്ച് യോഗങ്ങൾ മാത്രമേ നമ്മൾ ഉണ്ടാക്കാതെ ഉള്ളൂ എന്നാണ് എൻ്റെ ഓർമ്മ. അതില് നമ്മള് സ്മരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു വൈദ്യനാണ് മന്മഥൻ വൈദ്യൻ. അദ്ദേഹത്തിന്റെ എരിതൈലമാണ് ഗോപിയുടെ സബ്ജക്റ്റ് ആയിരുന്നത്. അതും ഒരുപാട് കേസുകൾ നമുക്ക് കിട്ടിയിട്ടുണ്ട്. എന്തായാലും നിങ്ങളൊക്കെ എന്റെ ഏറ്റവും ഞാൻ ഇഷ്ടപ്പെടുന്ന എല്ലാ ശിഷ്യഗണങ്ങളെയും എനിക്ക് വളരെ സ്നേഹവും വാത്സല്യവുമാണ്. അതിലൊരു വിദ്യാർത്ഥിയായിരുന്നു ഗോപി. എൻ്റെ ഓർമ്മ 2005-2008 ബാച്ചിലാണ് ഗോപി ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നതെന്നാണ്. എന്തായാലും നിങ്ങളെല്ലാം കേരളത്തിൽ അറിയപ്പെടുന്ന നല്ല വിഷവൈദ്യന്മാരായി, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അകതം പ്രാക്ടീസ് ചെയ്യുന്ന സയന്റിഫിക്കലി നിങ്ങൾ ഒരുപാട് ഇതിന്റെ പുറകിൽ അധ്വാനിക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. അപ്പോ എല്ലാരും ഇന്ന് കേരളത്തിൽ അറിയപ്പെടുന്ന വിഷവൈദ്യന്മാരായി നമുക്ക് തിരിച്ച് വിഷവൈദ്യത്തെ കേരളത്തില് അതിന്റെ വേരുറപ്പിക്കണം. ഇനി ഇത് ഡിക്ലൈൻ ചെയ്ത് പോയ ഒരു ശാസ്ത്രശാഖയാണ്. അപ്പൊ വീണ്ടും നിങ്ങളെപ്പോലുള്ളവര് രംഗത്ത് വന്ന് ഇത് വീണ്ടും തിരിച്ച് നമ്മുടെ വിഷചികിത്സ എത്രമാത്രം പ്രയോജനപ്പെടുന്നതാണെന്ന് ജനങ്ങൾക്ക് മനസ്സിലാക്കി കൊടുക്കണം. ഇത് എൻ്റെ ഒരു അഡ്വൈസാണ്. അപ്പോൾ ഇതിൽ പങ്കെടുക്കാൻ കഴിഞ്ഞത് എൻ്റെയും കൂടെ ഒരു ഭാഗ്യമായി ഞാൻ കരുതുന്നു ഈ വെബിനാറിൽ. അച്ചു
ടീച്ചറെ, നമുക്ക് ഭയങ്കര സന്തോഷം ടീച്ചറെ വിളിച്ച്
നിങ്ങള് എന്നെ ഓർത്തല്ലോ, അത് തന്നെ ഏറ്റവും വലിയ കാര്യം. അപ്പൊ ഗോപിയെ ഞാൻ മിക്കവാറും വിളിക്കാറുണ്ട്, മാസത്തിൽ ഒരു പ്രാവശ്യമെങ്കിലും ഗോപി എന്നാണ് ഇങ്ങോട്ട് വിളിക്കുന്നത്, സുഖവിവരങ്ങളൊക്കെ അറിയാനായിട്ട് വിളിക്കാറുണ്ട്. അപ്പൊ നമ്മളെപ്പോഴും ഒരു കോണ്ടാക്ട് ഉണ്ട്. വളരെ സന്തോഷം. പിന്നെ സമയം അതിക്രമിച്ചിരിക്കുകയല്ലേ, ഞാൻ നിർത്തുന്നു. നന്ദി, നമസ്കാരം. ഓക്കെ,
ഹലോ സാർ, കുറച്ച് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ചാറ്റ് ബോക്സിൽ വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഞാൻ വായിക്കാവേ. നവമി അജിത് ചോദിച്ചതാണ്, വിത്ത് ജീവരക്ഷ വിച്ച് അതർ ഡ്രഗ് ഇൻ എബോവ് കണ്ടീഷൻ യു മെൻഷൻഡ് എ തൈല, ഐ തിങ്ക് നോട്ട് ക്ലിയർ. ഒരു ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ആണ്. നവമി അജിത്.
ഒത്തിരി കമന്റ്സ് ഉണ്ടല്ലേ,
ആ കുറച്ച് മുകളിലോട്ട്.
സോ സോ ഒരു മിനിറ്റ്. ആ 922. ആ എന്താണ്, ഒന്നും കൂടി റിപ്പീറ്റ് വായിക്കോ.
വിത്ത് ജീവരക്ഷ വിച്ച് അതർ ഡ്രഗ്.
എരിതൈലം, എരിതൈലം, എരിതൈലം എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞൊരു, ഇറ്റ് വാസ് എരിതൈല. എരിതൈല ഈസ് എ ട്രഡീഷണൽ യോഗ. It is not available in the reference is not available in the textbooks, and it's a yoga practiced by my Vishwachikitsa teacher, Manmathan Vaidya. He is practicing in a remote village in Malappuram district. It's a forest area, a lot of snake bite cases and Lutha Visha and cases, a lot of Visha cases comes to his OP. So I had a chance to stay with him and learn Vishwachikitsa under him for a month duration, and that too twice. After my PG also I used to go there to learn from him. He is very old now, almost in the verge of stopping the practice because of one present situation. Erythaila is a wonderful yoga. It's available, and if at all we are not able to prepare these yogas, I'll be able to talk to sir and provide you the yogas. I shall share the number, and if at all medicines are needed, such cases come to you if you are able to, because I have only discussed about the practical aspect of the cases. What theory is running behind all these is another huge area, because the reference of which is is having the whole text at the same time. It is of gangrenous or necrotic conditions, or in pain predominant cases of visha, sarpa visha. Very teekshna yoga, and it's a druti yoga also. Some 37 ingredients are there in it. The yogas I can share. No problem. You can please contact the organizers for the PPT. I can share the PPT also.
ഹലോ സാർ, അടുത്തൊരു ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ. പെയിൻ ആൻഡ് വൈറ്റ് തിക് കോട്ടിംഗ് ഓൺ ടോപ്പ് ഓഫ് ടങ് വിത്ത് പെയിൻ സിവിയർ, വാട്ട് ക്യാൻ ബി ഡൺ സാർ?
ദാറ്റ്സ് വാട്ട് ഐ മൈ ഹോൾ ഇന്റൻഷൻ ഓഫ് പ്രസന്റേഷൻ വാസ് ടു അസസ് ദ സംപ്രാപ്തി ടു ഇറ്റ്സ് ഫുൾ വിത്ത് ദ ഡയറ്റ് ഹിസ്റ്ററി ആൻഡ് വിത്ത് ദ ഇൻവോൾവ്മെന്റ് വിത്ത് ദ വാട്ട് ടു സേ ദ നിദാനസ് he has been exposed. Can you please tell the details of the case other than this white coating for the past how many months or days or years, or what are the associated symptoms present and the age of the patient?
Hello sir, I'm Jebnia. Actually the age of the patient is around 60 years. after menopause, she had this problem. She already had thyroid problem as well, and she was taking medications for that. Since some 2 years back, it started with severe pain. First, there was a small clotting. Now it has become so much bigger, like a growth on top of the tongue with severe pain and whitish clotting. And in modern, they did biopsy and they said it's cancerous.
It's leukoplakia. Absolutely, it is leukoplakia. Now, we will be in need of a constant... are you managing the case now?
No, sir. No, right now they are doing allopathic treatments.
You can try with the our other yogas where in you can follow Malayalam, right? You can follow Malayalam.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes,
in
yes,
in Prayoga Samuchayam, in Prayoga Samuchayam, there are a few clinical features mentioned together. And in that, Vrana, once the management is done, initial management is done, there are a few yogas where Vrana is one of the indications. One thing which we discussed here, we can try with this. Where is the primary lesion? That has to be seen. In leukoplakia, it will be only a feature of a malignant lesion where the primary lesion may be somewhere else. That has to be properly evaluated. Then only we can try with the medicines, right? For that subsiding of leukoplakia, our nalpamaram kashayam regularly gandusha or kavala will be helpful. Nalpamaram or malati patra swarasa for gargling can be tried. But the primary lesion still is remaining. That is to be evaluated, right? Leukoplakia is just one of the features. That has to be seen. And if we get the full details, the full details of investigation, the full features, we can plan for a prescription. It's a planned approach that we may be in need of. For time being, for subsiding leukoplakia, we can try with that.
Sir, if you don't mind, can you please give me the contact number?
With the organizers.
Okay,
they'll be having. And for oral lichen planus, OLP is a very common presentation in our OP, right? You might have seen a lot of cases coming with dark patches all over, and the histopathology report may come as oral lichen planus. I have found a lot of result with the gudgula tiktaka grita, just a smearing of gudgula tiktaka grita all over, provided we should try a test dose of it. There may not be any allergy. Google Tiktaka Krita smeared and Murwadi Gutika internally has provided a very encouraging result in OLP cases. Okay, just for the clinical interest, I told it may be out of the topic today.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, next question. A patient complained of skin eruption with itching, especially during morning and evening. The condition subsides on exposure to sunlight. What can be the diagnosis and the treatment?
Kandu is a kapaja nanatmaja vikara as per Charaka. Kandu is a kapaja nanatmaja vikara. Either it can be due to the external factors, and this single logic of kapaja nanatmaja vikara is very much relevant in your this presentation question, right? Once it is exposed to sunlight, it subsides. Is a classical feature. What we try in our OP is application of Dinesha Valyadi Keram. Dinesha Valyadi Keram. If the patient is very old, very senior, dry skin can also induce itching. Or else, simple taking bath with cold water. There are patients who complain about itching, severe itching after taking bath, especially in the evening hours. So such conditions can be effectively managed with Dinesha Valyadi external application. Keram Velichanna is better choice. Dinesha Valyadi Velichanna. Tapaja Nanabhanda Vikara, a single diagnosis is that one. If no other features are there, eruptive lesions are not there, wheals are not there, or articarial lesions are not there, or papular rashes are not arising, such things, simple application of Dinesha Valiyadi once in a day can come to the help.
Okay, sir. Another question. A child with eczema on joint of hands and at back of knees treatment.
Is that eczema or is that a fungal infection? Because there is a very small difference in between the presentation of a fungal infection and eczema on the flexures. Flexures are the common site for settlement of dust as well as sweat. So first we have to rule out whether it is fungal infection or this one. If oozing is there, if oozing or the skin is very much thick, I prefer patola mooladi kashaya for parisheka. Its churna is available. We can get patola mooladi churna from pharmacies. We can use a diluted kashaya, 1 teaspoon with 2 liters of water, and then wash it. So if we dissect the dosha predominance in it, it has to be vata kapaja. If oozing is there, we can prefer patola mooladi. If the skin is thick, dry, and itching is there, eladi or coconut oil, and then wash it with simple salt water will be enough if the lesion is dry. Internally, if it's a boy, a small child, boy or a girl, always child, Krimihara Chikitsa will be favoring the condition. Krimihara Chikitsa. I think I have answered. Next.
Okay, sir. Next question. There is a specific type of skin disease, like a small mustard-like appearance, which start at joints, present on dorsal surface in hands and the ventral surface on legs. What type of Kushta is it? And
Prinoderma. Prinoderma. It is usually seen in children. In these areas, there will be papular rash on the extensor surface of the elbow. And the area may be dark also. A little bit off color will be there. Normal skin color, and at the same time that particular joint area will be there. It is commonly due to the deficiencies. And we can try with the first Krimihara Chikitsa can be tried. What we prescribe in our OP is Krimihara Chikitsa, and then external application of two or three possibilities are there. External application of Eladi Velichanna, Eladi Keram, and Rajanyadi Churna for a prolonged use. Rather than if children, 1/2 teaspoon BD or 1 teaspoon BD will be sufficient. One single medicine is enough. Rajanyadi Churna, 1 teaspoon with the hot water, and external application of Eladi after Krimihara Chikitsa. And external contact of dust or soil or in small children especially. If it is in an adult age, now the samprakti changes. The patient may be obese. Usually such presentations we come across in our OP. In obese patient, we have to think of Vidhi Shonitiya Samprakti of Charaka Samhita Sutrasthana 24. In that you can see the characteristic this feature. In such condition, we have to treat with the Shonitaja Roga Chikitsa. I think I have answered.
Okay. So next question, how to prepare Erythaila Yoga?
Erythaila Yoga is a Dhruti Yoga actually. We need to, I think in Trivandrum, my department, I had a video of the preparation of Erythaila. It's a lengthy procedure. Two rods are required, iron rods of say one of 2 feet and another of 1 feet length. 1 feet length or 1.5 and 3, which is long enough for us to hold. And two cloths are needed, which should cover 1/3 of those respective rods, cotton cloth. And these prescribed, these mentioned drugs in that yoga are to be prepared in the form of a kvatha churna, and they are to be kept in a bowl, a wide steel vessel. And tila taila, nalikera taila, and grita, 700 ml each. 700 ml each and 10 eggs are needed. It's a binding agent actually, 10 eggs. And that egg white portion only should be used. And those 10 eggs should be cut open and then yellow portion should be discarded. That should not be used. Only white should be put. And then mix it with our hand very well. Those kwata churna and this one should be mixed very well. And in another patram, in another vessel, 700 ml of tilathaila, 700 ml of drita and 700 ml of nalikera thaila should be mixed together. Mixed together. So we have one kalka in our hand in one patra and another patra, this snigdha dravya. And with a very broad, a very good clean cloth, we have to keep this powdered powder mixed with the that egg white in a shade. Direct sunlight is not necessary. In a shade, we have to keep it for 1 hour. Then that kora cloth, that cotton cloth which we had cut into the required size, one for a longer rod, which should cover 1/3, for a shorter iron rod, which should cover 1/3. We should keep it in a table, spread, and proportionately, we have to spread this powder, evenly spread this powder in both these cloths. And then this rod should be kept on that cloth, and this should be rolled to form one third, this the drug stuffed cloth will be there. And with an iron wire, with a metal wire, we have to tie it. We have to tie it with a crisscross pattern like this, X-shaped crisscross pattern. We should try. One round should come like this and another in the opposite direction it should go, so that the tied portion will look like an X, a crisscross iron wire should be tied on both the rod. So we have two rods which are already now with the drug, that cloth will be stuffed with that drug. And we should be now, next thing we need is broad vessels, two broad vessels. One we are already having, where drita, taila and nalikera taila is put, and another bigger vessel is needed. Tamra is preferably tamra. And we have to lift this cloth. Now the every procedure is similar, druti yoga. And the bigger rod, the bigger rod should be placed above, and with another hand the shorter rod should be below. And this shorter rod is igniting the larger rod, and it should keep on burning. And we should put this drita, the mixture of this snigdha dravya, into the bigger rod, and it will keep on burning. And this burning process, that oil will keep on dribbling to that vessel, similar to a druti yoga. And this process should be repeated for 6 to 7 times. Now, when the paka is ready, we cannot see the oil dribbling. Instead of that, we can see the fire dribbling. The fire itself will be dribbling down. Now that is the indicator for completion of the paka. We have to allow it to dry and then filter it with a cloth and keep it in a glass jar. It is used for external application, and very rarely it can be used for internal administration also, and that too in a complicated case of cobra bite or a viper bite. Complicated cases where the recovery chance is very low because of very severe drastic symptoms. In such patients, 8 drops of erythailam with 1 glass of milk should be given in a day, 1 day dose. It can be given in 2 drops 4 times a day, or 4 drops 2 times a day. The choice is left to us. Only that is the therapeutic dose of that. But I have not seen for a single patient, even till my Guruji has given that internally, not seen a single case for the past 12 years, because that will not be necessary. In asadhya lakshana, there is no way for the patient to survive. In such drastic or severe features, erythailam can be used internally. But it's a very rare phenomenon where Vaidya, I have not seen Guruji using it for the past 12 years.
Okay, sir. Next question. Tinea infection, how can we manage effectively?
In my usual prescription is advice, proper advice of hygiene that he has to follow for the rest of his life. Proper hygiene. And for medication, I prefer Guluchari Kashaya and Guluchari Kashaya for Pana. And two choice usually for Parisheta. One I already told in the cases of Kapha dominant conditions and oozing is there, Patola Mooladi for Parisheta. And if not, if you Paithika features are there, then Tribala Churna is choice. That will be enough. Every time we should remember that Sheetala Parisheta is to be preferred. Sheetala Parisheta, not warm. Warmth and lack of sunlight, sweat, dust are all favorable factors for such fungal infection. So better to advise the patient not to expose or not to, every time if he is exposed to such things, he will have recurrent features. So better to advise a proper hygienic regimen to the patient together with the prescribing the medicine. And also not warm Kashaya for Parisheta. It should be cold itself.
Okay, sir. And next question. How to assess Gara inner disease?
Nidana. That's what I told. Because Samprapti may need a lot of time, doctor. Samprapti to assess Gara is a different, is a separate session. We may require 2 hours at least. Because Gara is not a disease. It's a spectral disorder. It's a spectral presentation. That's why in between Murwadi, I took time to give you a hint how to refer this Garavisha in the textbook and how to interpret and what is the pattern of approach in management. Because we get the patient of Pandu. We get the patient of Jwara, Kasa, Shwasa, and Udavarta, and depressed patient. We get cases of ascites. We get cases of hepatosplenomegaly. We get cases of skin disorder. We get multiple system involved autoimmune disorders. All these conditions, if we go through a prompt assessment through Nidana and Samprapti, we can assess Gara. Now, Gara is not a diagnosis actually. Gara is a spectral presentation, a cluster of disorder. Again, I remind you to refer Yogaraja Churna and Kautaja Tripala, Sharagada, mentioned in the Charaka Samhita, three different yogas in different chapters and the Lakshana of Gara. Surprisingly, all these four have similar presentation. So instead of thinking that the patient may come with these Lakshanas, better to think that the patient has come to us with the Pandu, whether he is having a factor of Gara in him or not. Now, what is Gara is to be discussed now. It can be our faulty diet, our faulty lifestyle, our faulty regimen for a long period, so that we have given enough time for accumulation of the dosha in the body, sufficient enough to create a new disorder. In a single word, Gara is that one. Now, if time permits, in another day or another session, we will discuss only on Gara, because that may require 1.5 hours at least.
Okay, sir. Next question. Concept of Punaravartaka Jwara with clinical examples. Explain.
In Charaka, Chikitsa Sana, third chapter, if we refer this Punaravartaka Jwara concept, there is a recurrent manifestation of Jwara. Now, put out of your mind that Jwara is fever. Jwara is only a presentation there. It's only a Lakshana of another disorder. Now, coming to the Punaravartaka Jwara. It's only a symptom there. There is disease is something else. Presentation is Jwara. In that perspective, If you refer Charaka Samhita, Chikitsa Sthana 3rd chapter, Punaravartaka Jwara concept, there we can get 10 or 12 lines reference where they are 5 to 6 systemic illness symptoms. Out of this, Ojas is there, joint pathology is there, skin manifestation is there, lifestyle disorder is there. All these cluster of symptoms are mentioned in that single line of Punaravartaka Jwara concept. So how to assess is a challenge, because we should be able to pick the Nidana, his diet habits, and whether he is being presented with Jwara. Now, Ayurveda textbook is basically symptomatic. This may be a huge controversial statement that I am going to tell you. It is symptomatic. Why I am telling symptomatic? Because we judge that particular patient according to the presenting complaints. Because a Gilbert syndrome can be Prameha, not Kamala. Not always Kamala. It can be Prameha also. A case of hematuria and a case of renal cell carcinoma can be Kshatakshina, not Arbuda. Because we are depending upon the textbook. We are depending upon the words of the patient, what he is mentioning to us, what are his concerns, and we are going to ask him questions regarding his associated symptoms. So on the main complaint, it is our duty to search in the textbook, how can a patient be presenting in front of us with this cluster of features? According to that, we decide the medicine. That is why Punaravartaka Jwara is such an area where a case of skin disorder, who is having Jwara as a predominant feature and who has a tendency to go for immunological assay, if we see IgE in him, invariably IgE will be raised. Now, seeing that IgE is raised, he is having skin disorder, we can never think of a Manjushtadikashaya or a Guduchyadikashaya in such a patient. In such patients, we definitely will bank upon such yogas, which is Tikta in nature, which is Laghu in nature, which is Ruksha in nature, which is naturally an Anulomana in nature. We can come to a conclusion by assessing the Samprapti in such patient. So we can only think of Punaravartaka Jwara in that case. Because skin disorder is not only mentioned in Kushta and Visarpa. Out of 30 chapters of Charaka Samhita, nearly 18 to 19 chapters have skin disorders, including Jwara and Vata Vyadi. You see Twaggata Vata, you see Ratta Avrata Vata, you see Charaka Sutrasthana chapter number 23. In 23, you can get skin disorder of an entirely different Samprapti. It is Medha Savrata Vata Samprapti, where Medha Sanchaya is causing Kleda Adhikya in a patient and he is landing upon a disorder of skin. Now, if we treat him with Manjushtadi, what may be our result? We will be doomed. Failure. Again, in that Medha's condition also, there is skin. In Vidishonitiya Samprapti, there is skin. In Sutrasthana Ashayapakarsha, there is skin. In Jwara, there is skin. In Vata Vyadi, again, there is skin. In Vata Rakta, there is skin. So, the interpretation of our textbook and its perspective is entirely different. The way of reading has to be changed. So, in that small boy, for example, every child who is presented with this pattern of Visarpa, Parisarpana Swabhavat Visarpa, only that word, if we suspect Visarpa in such condition with the fever, now it is our duty to control the fever. In Vata Vyadi, there is one reference of Chakrapani reference, where whenever we have Pitta and Kapha associated with Vata, treat Pitta. Samsrishte Kapha Pitta Abhyam Pittam Adau Vinirjayet. For that, Chakrapani mentions why Pitta Madhav Vinirjayet. He mentions Pittasya Ashukarikvat. Pitta is very fast. It is angry. It is drastic. It gets angry very fast. So manage Pitta first. So what to do? Passive pitta first, think of kapha later. So this is the principle that we have to apply when there is an acute onset of a skin disorder in such children. They are very hard. That's why I muted the voice. That boy was crying like anything. And in the second video, he is singing 4 days. That is what a Vishasamprapti in Jwara and that particular yoga can render a result. I think I have answered.
Okay. Sir, there are few more questions. May I?
Okay. If your time is okay, if audience are not complaining, then no problem.
Okay. Tinea corporis in different parts, what medicine? What medicine will be helpful?
Even we had been in a situation where tinea corporis had to be managed by giving vamana. Such a huge infection can occur. A lady who was obese, who was dyslipidemic, developed tinea all over the body. Shamanaushadhi was not sufficient for her. We subjected her for vamana. We subjected her for virechana. Then started Shamanaushadhi. And by 6 months of treatment, she was able to be freed from that tinea infection. This is one extreme. I think you remember that elbow of that boy, 2 lesions. It was there on his groin also, on his trunk also. But with the our Pottam Thagaradi and Neeli Tulasiadi yoga, such conditions can be managed very effectively. And one freedom of using an Agada yoga that we get in tinea itself, and not in all the other cases also, we can apply. Agada yoga is lenient in its mode of administration. We can use it as a kashaya, for pana, for kshalana, for nasya, for anjana, for lepa. All the freedom, all the lenience we have when we use an Agada yoga. You see many yogas. First example is Bilwari. And again, Lodhar Sevyadi is also another example in Ashtanga Hriday itself. You see, in Lodhar Sevyadi, he has given us freedom. Use it in any way. In any way you use. That is the freedom that we get when we use. Even Bilwadi Agada, I have used to prepare a kashaya of it and used for Parisheta in tinea corporis. Bilwadi Churna was prepared, kashaya was done, Parisheta was given. Sheetala Parisheta, always think Sheetala. So extreme cases. In Vata Kapha condition all over the body, do Patola Mooladi, add Aragvada Patra to it. Because kapham aragvadhadina, in Dushi Visha, if you see the reference in Charaka Samhita, you can see kapham aragvadhadina. Aragvada adi drugs are very effective in managing kapha predominant conditions of Dushi Visha. With Patola Mooladi, use Aragvada Patra for Parisheka. That will be helpful. For internally, if the patient is not having any constipation, we can use Bilwadi very effectively. Before and after food, Bilwadi prescription, its action changes. After food, it's a very good pachan dravya. Before food, it can induce constipation in a longer duration of prescription. By keeping this thing in mind, we can keep on changing. Guluchi Adhikashaya is a yoga we can use. Patola Mooladi for Parisheka we can use. Guluchi Adhi we can use for Parisheka also. Preferably with the kapha predominant condition. And if the condition is pitta dominant, even Patyaksha Dhatri Adi Kashaya has also been used for Parisheka. Patyaksha Dhatri Adi Kashaya of Shalakya area, and that Kashaya has been used for Parisheka for cases where there is pitta predominant lesions were there. Big palm size lesion. But that case which we saw, that is the case which we had used Agada Yoga. For that, we had used Neeli Tulasi Adi. Internally as well as externally, that has come to a wonderful help for that boy. I think I have given the choice.
Okay, sir. Next question. For pemphigoid vulgaris, please guide for line of treatment.
Pemphigus vulgaris is...
And she is from West Bengal, and also asked that how can she get the medicine?
Lodras Aviary is a wonderful drug. Lodras Aviary is available in, I think, Vaidyaratnam Aushadhashala prepares Lodras Aviary. And Everest Pharmacy is also having Lodras Aviary yoga. And or else we can prepare. Preferences Ashtanga Hridaya, Luta, Visha, Adhikara. And pemphigus needs admission, first point. And it needs a lot of care, because only dangerous skin disorder in front of us, which has been a challenge for a long period, is pemphigus itself. And the next to it is only such skin disorders which come to the children. And it requires admission. And constant jwara and visarpa chikitsa are to be gone in tandem. In jwara and visarpa chikitsa should be in tandem. That too, if we get a yoga, which all these things are in common, like Lodras Aviary is one yoga, and in our yoga, Taruna Bhaskara is another yoga. We can use it effectively. And Musta Ramachari Kashayam or Neeli Karanjari Kashayam. Neeli Karanjari case specificity, because of that, today's photo, no Neeli Karanjari prescription, so not added. In Moshika Visha Prakarana, all these yogas, stage by stage, we may have to change. But first and foremost prescription which comes to our mind is Tripala Kvata for Virechana and Lodra Sevyadi Kashaya for Pana and for internal administration, Visha Vilvadi Gutika. It is the first thing that we have to start with. Then we can go on changing. And instead of using thick lepa, churna or kalka lepa to the patient, there are all the chances of contamination at times. If we are not able to take care of the patient or bystander is a little bit negligent, there can be the chances of exacerbation of the feature if we use kalka. So better to use a kashaya yoga for parisheka of the same kalka which you had intended. You might have a plan of treatment in front of you when you see a patient. So better to use parisheka instead of using kalka for application, because contamination safety issue. So by in that order, we can go on treating the case. Visarpa and jwara should be kept in mind. I think I have answered.
Okay. Next question. Can we manage Mukha Dushika as Dushi Visha?
Yes. Yes, we can. And Pitta is to be taken care of in such condition, and we should rule out any hormonal imbalances there in the patient. Obesity, Stavya Samprapti, or any Stri Roga, if happens to be a female, then that is also to be assessed. And a common cause of acne in temple or in forehead area is dandruff. Such questions should not be missed. If it is in the cheek or in this area of chin, usually it can be hormonal in nature. And Pitta should be taken care of. Such yoga should be selected.
Okay, last question. 25-year-old female complained of tiny pustule on upper back, neck and face. And after pustular stage, it become blackish spot, which persists for a long time. I think itching or aching pain, etc. are not there. What can we do?
Is the patient obese?
So the question is from YouTube viewers.
So they can't respond. Okay. For them. See, this Samprapti is having a unique nature. We already discussed, actually. This case we have already discussed. Female, right?
Yes, female, 25-year-old female.
25, yes. If the patient is obese, if the patient is not obese, two possibilities there. And the diet pattern is also very, very important. If the diet is pakka perfect, the patient is very particular on the diet. Now, next factor we have to think is, so Gara is ruled out. Gara is ruled out. Now, diet is perfect. Her habits are very, very proper. The dressing method, everything is proper, cotton and not going on in the afternoon sunlight, she is not exposed to. Now, Gara is left, ruled out. Now, if yes, if it is a case of Gara, now Morvadi should be the first choice. Morvadi with Kottam Tagaradi Kashayam. We discussed it, Kottam Tagaradi. Yashti Madhu, Tagara, Kushta, Chandana, Ushira, and Sariva. This is one of the choice because we have to see, we have to make sure that Kleda factor is pulled out. That is cleared. Then we can think of Parisheta. Now, as I told earlier, we have a lenience of using an other yoga externally as well as internally, the same yoga, but different preparation. One should be Chaturthavashesha Kashaya, other should be for Kashaya. We need to boil it and then cool it and then filter it and then use it. So this one aspect. Another is if obese and not obese. If the patient is obese, now the patient should be seen through the Sutrasthana 23rd chapter Samprati. Langana Pramaniya and next chapter Santarpaniya. In that, Charaka gives a Lakshana complex, a group of features. That should be managed in that Medho Vikara. Medho Vikara. And why Medho Vikara? Because Prameha is not diabetes. With that bail, I'm starting. In Sushruta, if you see Nidanasthana, Pushta and Prameha are mentioned together. Pushta and Prameha are mentioned together. If you see Gayadasa commentary, he tells Medha and Rakta are Kleda Pradhana Drava Dhatu. Probably that can cause the disorder in a cluster formation, both Medhas as well as Rakta. So one aspect is clear. We have to think in that line. If the patient is Pitta predominant and the patient is having Rakta Dushti, with these pustules or vesicles and then getting black, immediate chapter 24th Sutrasthana Vidishonitya Tataha Shonitaja Rogaha Prajayante Pratakvidha should be seen. That line, it is the first line. Tata Shonitaja Rogaha Prajayante Pratakvidha Mukaroga Asya Pakashta. That one group is mentioned. In that, one area is your patient. One area, single area is your patient. Now there is Grahani in it, there is Visarpa in it, there is Kushta in it, there is joint pain in it. All the things are different discussion topics. One area is this one. We have to manage with the Rakta as a causative factor. These three areas are there. I think I have answered. Medicine, I am not the authority person to talk about medicine, talk about prescription. It is left to the individual physician. I am telling about the samprapti, the probable samprapti that can run in that particular case. Prescription, we are free to decide. I think I have answered.
Okay, sir. I think we covered all the questions in the chat section. So anything else you want to say before I wrap up?
Take proper Nidana.
Okay.
Because for an Agada practice, I am not talking as an Agada person, or I am not a mouthpiece of Agada Tantra. I work in the aspect of my specialized area. I am trying level best to justify the science with the proper samprapti. Every time there is a chance that to bring every condition under Agada. Oh, this is mentioned in Agada. This is mentioned in Vishishikitsa. It is our area. No, that need not be every time. Because every disease has a group of Nidanas. Out of this, one can be Visha. One can be Gara. One classical example is in Unmada Nidana. Unmada Chikitsa, Charaka, 9th chapter. If you see, Charaka mentions about Viruddha, Dushta, Ashuchi, Bhojanani. First line of Nidana, Viruddha, Dushta, Ashuchi, Bhojanani. In that, if you see Chakrapani commentary, Viruddha, Dushta, immediately he mentions Dushta, Garadav. So Visha is there in Unmada also. So it is not not the thing that we need to bring everything under Visha Chikitsa, but there can be a case where Visha can be a Nidana. So it is our duty to elicit whether that particular nidana is running in the patient, whether that nidana is a causative factor for development of samprapti in the patient. According to that, we have to treat. Then only there can be completion of treatment. I think my message is clear. Taking nidana, assessing the samprapti is the prime thing that we need to decide a prescription in a patient.
Okay, sir. Thus we come up to the end of a section. Before winding up, let me thank our eminent guest, Dr. Gobi Krishna, Assistant Professor, VPSB Ayurveda College, Kottakkal, for accepting our invitation without any refusal. Sir, the presentation was really informative and great, especially the Q&A section. I take this opportunity to extend my sincere gratitude to Dr. Gobi Krishnan on behalf of GDAH Kerala and AMAI Artingal Area Committee. Next, I would like to extend my sincere gratitude to each and every delegate for attending this webinar. It's been 10:15. Thank you for being with us till the end. Apologizing for the delay due to network issues and other inconveniences. I hope the program like this would definitely come up again, bringing more knowledge and opportunity to the present era and practitioners. Once again, I thank you all. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.